Welcome back to Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. This time, we're heading into the final part of the game. We're heading into the casino, and then, you know, we'll get the grand finale of the game. And the casino, you've actually seen it before if you've played Thug 2 Remix. This is the Las Vegas level, actually.
I always thought it was so weird that this stuff was here and it didn't do anything.
Yeah, it's like...
I think it's cool decoration, though.
Laser just... grids, and I think that's like a Mission Impossible reference or something, but yeah. You just ride through
it. It's cool decoration, but this casino seems to be abandoned, so...
Yeah. That's the, the thing. The casino's abandoned, so you can destroy it up for the cool final part of the video. But yeah, it's the Las Vegas level minus,
minus the elevator.
That was a
very
request.
The Despacito Spider.
It's very good. I like the name.
Why is it called that, though?
It's what the guy requested I name it.
Okay.
But yeah, without the central elevator that in Thug 2 Remix got you up to the different floors and such. So a little bit simplified, but mostly the same.
I forgot it came this late in the game. For some reason, I thought it was earlier. I forgot this was back here too, huh?
Oh, good. They keep all this.
Yeah, and like, Iggy's with you now, so. Yeah,
aim at the old ladies. Okay.
Yo, yeah. Snapperhead, I got a job for you. See that trippy thing hanging above the pool? I want it for my ranch. It ain't gonna be easy to get to, so try this combo. Acid drop off the diving board into the pool. Next, spine transfer to the pool below. After that, get big air and stall on the rails. That should do it. Either that or I can go and grab some spare dynamite I have lying around somewhere. Yeah, let's try this first.
Wasn't this basically a challenge in Underground 2 Remix?
Yeah.
You have to spy crash through all the pools?
Iggy talks with such authority, I love it.
Yeah.
Got a little too much air there.
It went a little too fast for me.
What?
I'll remember when it comes up, but there's a pretty funny glitch that happened to me in this one.
You didn't even... Like, do it.
No, he did it on the second try.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, they don't make you stall there at all, do they?
This is kind of weird.
They make you stall there for a moment.
It's kind of weird. You do that first half, and then, like, Iggy teleports down here with another challenge. So I guess they think you're, like, immediately going to do it.
You're knee-deep in water.
At the 11th hour, the game remembered that vert wall plants are still in here, and so they asked you to do one.
Oh, I forgot vert wall plants were in here at all.
Yeah?
Why would you need to do more than one
and
in the entire game?
I'm trying. Every time I pass by it, I'm trying.
Seems like it's difficult to do just one, so maybe it's good that they don't ask us to do another.
I'm fucking trying.
This time, you got it. This time.
Yeah! Yeah, there we go.
So yeah, everyone if I look up other videos and people do that challenge, they always get pushed away from the wall. So I wonder, did they like change up vert wall plants to actually possibly do something and then still like not make you do it at all? Oh, and also this two-tail mechanic, which you've also been able to do the whole game, but they only ask you to actually do it once.
Two-tail, what?
It's like, you'll see skaters do this in real life while they're like, go up a quarter pipe, drop back in, and like hit the back of their board against the rail.
Yeah. I did not know that was in this game at all. Legit,
that's how
100%,
Madonna is
I didn't know it was in
that.
This game.
I mean, it's a thing that makes a lot more sense when you, you know, only get enough air to do a quick little trick rather than, like, five backflips.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you watch Tony Hawk, like, teach someone how to do a Madonna, that's, like, how you land a Madonna. And, like, landing your tail on the floor, on the coping.
Coping, yeah. And a hot
tub for them to swim around. Yeah.
Oh, there's no subtitles at all for that one.
Not that middle
gave
one.
Up. Gave up. For a little bit. You know, it would be great it's back again.
I mean, everyone's heard of Smokin' Hot Casino Babes, right?
Yeah.
But has anyone heard of Smokin' Hot, oil ranchers who come out to casinos to blow all their money?
I mean, the high roller, you know, and Thug 2 Remix was, you know, he was rocking that suit pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
He was.
I'd say he was pretty smoking hot.
Yeah.
Oh,
my
Yeah.
I forgot. Someone in the comments can probably answer this. Does when you do stalls like this, it uses your grind balance meter, right? And not your lit balance meter?
I think so.
Yeah, I think it does.
Huh.
I remember watching some. There's a fantastic video, I think video series out there on YouTube about
we're taking off.
Oh my fucking god, you went off into fucking orbit.
Yeah.
Goodbye. Wow. But there's a great video series on YouTube about someone like scientifically. It's like a 40-minute long video of someone scientifically going through and proving like how the balance meters in at least Thug Pro work in the game, like what contributes to your balance like getting worse over time.
Huh.
Like, is it doing more in one combo? Is it just the length of the manual that you're doing in one combo?
And yes, this is happening.
Yeah.
I wish it wasn't.
It's just supposed to be like a hallucination or something. But I don't know.
Get special, then transfer your special powers.
I don't know. He came back.
Over your white boyfriend, dumbass.
All right, all right. Don't get all Kung Fu Jackie Chan on me and stuff.
Yo, the 20s.
Oh, he's gone. Oh, okay. He's not. Thank God.
Yeah, Kanaka, I actually know what you're talking about. I'll just link it.
Yeah.
Is that, they have the source code to that now, right?
Thug Pro or Thug 2?
No. I mean, like, the Thug 2, like, they've dissected the engine and they can, like, look at how it all works now, haven't they?
I would not know.
Okay.
That the way that guy did it was very, like, rudimentary, like, I am going to do everything that that one would think would affect, like...
Because I know that the Tony Hawk's Underground 1 source code is... Somebody leaked it a long time ago. Like, you can't compile it or anything, but you can look at it.
Okay.
You can see, like, the physics and everything. I don't actually know if that contains, like, the gameplay elements or just all the back, you know, backbone stuff.
Back-end stuff.
Yeah, I was
back
gonna end say, stuff. Like...
But you can see, like, how they did gravity calculations and everything else that's in there. And you can read a bunch of... like comments, and it has some interesting insights into PS2 architecture as well. There's some comments on it that are like, you don't write anything below this point or else that's the PS2 won't work correctly or something.
Oh, there goes the escalator.
Huh.
And there's a comment below that that said, haha, fuck you Sony, I wrote something below this point.
Oh,
it was commented out so it doesn't read it, whatever he wrote below that point.
I brought the modified telescope shooter from the ranch. Just in case.
Oh, it's a telescope shooter.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, you're gonna remember this,
place is supposed to be vacant.
Yeah, why would you?
Busload of old ladies didn't get the memo.
Check it out. Oh my god! Sweet. What is wrong with you?
The good thing about old ladies is that they
are like a fine wine that ripens with age.
What the fuck?
No, they move slowly and they make for great targets.
What is wrong with
Let
you two?
That shooter.
Bombs away!
I was worried about this. You all were like, yes, more Iggy, and I'm like, well, this is like Neversoft's one chance to ruin Iggy by having him, you know, talk and have a bunch of lines.
Yeah, so, they tried to ruin my boy, but I'm gonna stand for Iggy anyway and just say that this is this is out of character.
All right, so
the good thing about Iggy or the good thing about old ladies is that I keep getting older and they stay the same age.
Okay, so here's a glitch. I don't know how it happened, but note that, like, there's the compass. I'm actually riding around instead of being in this cutscene. I don't know what it did, but yeah, I'm supposed to be standing there with the boys, you know, not able to, like, move, but I'm, like, you know, riding around and skating.
You're out of there. You're gone.
Yeah.
I'll say this didn't happen to me on both Xbox and 360.
Yeah, I can go into focus mode and slow the cutscene down. Yeah, unfortunately, I was nowhere near there, so I couldn't, like, get myself in there. It would have been fun.
Oh, man. That's amazing.
So, yeah, like, on Xbox 360, has that happened to anyone? Like, they keep control of the character even when it should be a cutscene? I don't know.
I can answer that question. Yes, it happened to you.
Yeah, no, that happened on Xbox 360.
Anyone happened to anyone else? Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, no,
leave us a comment if it happened to you too.
Maybe I just invented the sickest new speedrun strat, you know? Blindly navigate yourself blindly through an area to get straight to the next waypoint or something.
Yeah, if someone knew like the perfect inputs to actually like get you closer to where you need to be, I'd imagine that'd be useful.
So yeah, anyway, that cutscene was supposed to be like, hey, we've done enough at the casino. You can leave if you want, or you can keep doing challenges. And, you know, since we're only here once, I'm just gonna do the other challenges.
My man!
Once again, yeah, just show you everything in the casino, once again. Based on the difficulties, that changes how many missions you have to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
What a wonderful, realistic dynamic these two characters have.
You are going to die.
That's how me and Connor talk to each other.
You're dead, Bob.
Shut up, fat boy.
It's like, hey, I got a challenge for you to do. Bob totally beefed it. Oh, and here's another glitch.
Speaking of beefing it.
And yes, as soon as this happens, I decided to T-pose.
He's asserting his dominance.
I'm asserting dominance on all of you right now.
I like how you don't get any points for being in the air or anything. No, you just.
Actually is like a limit to how many tricks you can do. Like eventually, if you like just get enough points, it'll stop.
You got out of there. Hang on, does that mean you could have done like infinite amounts of whatever
and
got like the most insane score in the world?
I don't even know what happened.
Out of there?
No, Canuck was just saying.
Like, there is a cap to how many points you can get.
No, not infinite, like, literally infinite, but, like, you could have just done, like, a really super
huge combo. I could have stayed in
there,
like, forever.
No, it's, like, a pretty low point. Like, I did something that got me caught somewhere, and I did 5 Indy 900s, and it stopped giving me points. That may have just been a Thug 2 thing.
For Indy 900s, or just for anything in general?
I think anything in general.
I don't think people get stuck in the geometry enough to really test it, but hey, if you have an Xbox 360 copy, go try to do what I just did, or any copy, I don't know. It only happened to me that one time. It's kind of, yeah. I'm not even going to say the casino is glitchy, because like my first time through the game, those didn't happen. It just so happened to happen while recording.
You know, I'm still thinking about that you still moving during the cutscene thing. If you could do that with other cutscenes, like there's so many cutscenes in this game, I guess you can just skip the cutscenes.
Yeah, you can mostly just hit A and mash through them, and it's like, hey, what? Don't, but, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All the classic insetic noises.
Yeah, just an entire sound effects bank playing one after another.
What's that classic insetic noise that you always do in every LP?
Oh, right, the insetic scream.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. I haven't verified this is an insetic video yet. All right, there we go.
What LP was that when we were doing that?
I don't even remember.
I don't remember.
I forgot about it.
That was years ago.
I know. Wasn't the scooter one, was it?
No, that would have been way too early.
The scooter one, one of the scooter ones when we kept doing insetics without insetics, remember?
I'm trying to remember. I think that was Amped 2 that was insetic without insetic.
No, it was the scooter one because I was on. It was the suburb level of some scooter game that wasn't the Razor Freestyle one. It was a different scooter game.
World Tour.
Was it World Tour? Yeah, we did insetic without insetic like three times.
Oh, yeah, there were a couple of those.
Man.
And then,
I haven't really missed out on my own videos in a while.
You had to verify it was, it
a
was
true
you
insetic.
With an insetic
and wasn't there a blank tester screech as well?
Yeah, there was. I don't remember what it sounded like.
Yeah. Just one of those weird noises you made along the way.
Yeah.
Maybe was that the true friends? Was the true friends the weird noises we made along the way?
Right.
Matt, do you have any identifiable noises that you make?
Yeah, my laugh.
Yeah, Matt's uproarious laughter. Which, yeah.
That laugh, yeah.
It's good.
Yeah,
it's good. People like the laugh.
I don't have anything except my hyena screech whenever
it's
I
not
want.
Nothing's funny. I just do the laugh because I know it gets you views, you know?
Right.
I never just It's here for the view, you know, here for the laugh.
Oh man, that was awesome! Dude, you tore that casino up!
Got the DV! This video is gonna sell
gangbusters! Yeah, we destroyed property. Just because it's abandoned doesn't mean people don't live there.
Take that footage at all costs.
It's an allegory for the skate ranch.
Alright, so it's the final mission. It's the final mission. Yes, it does make it nighttime on you.
Perfect.
But yeah, you need to get back to the ranch and, you know, not get caught by the cops. So basically, you'll have a time limit to get from one area to the next, but you'll get checkpoints at every area along the way. There'll be some cops out on the ground, but there's also the helicopter over you, and if you stay in the, you know, beam of light too long, if it gets its attention on you for too much time, it will reset you. But you don't need to, like, bob and weave super hard to avoid it, just, you know, don't crash. It's basically, if you crash, you get sent back, and once again, I would have liked to make this look smooth, but there was always some fucking jank every single little area. It kind of annoyed me. But it's not like super interesting, hard.
Because earlier this morning, I was reading about this really cult classic video game known as Alan Wake.
Mm-hmm.
This kind of seems reminiscent of that or something. I don't know. That
was are you joking when you say cult classic?
Yes, presumably.
Okay. Because it's sort of a cult classic.
Yeah, it disappeared for a long time.
Yeah, because they lost the music license.
Yeah, you couldn't play it for... And it came back recently, didn't it?
Yeah.
Like, pretty recently, you can finally play it.
It's a great game.
I missed out on it the first time. I should probably try and get it as soon as possible before it goes away again.
I don't think it... Well, it might.
Yeah.
You never know.
Yeah.
So it's
That's
just like...
What it reminded me of. Like, you know, you can't stay in the flashlight for too long.
Yeah. So it's just like, kind of... Really showing to you, you know, one last time, everything's interconnected.
I like your bales.
Seriously, God, why did I fucking crash?
I love your bales so much.
And I guess I'll just also point out now, the final cutscene, I did have to add some extra music in there, because, of course, Neversoft used the one song on the soundtrack that gets my video globally blocked in 2020. So, I had to stick some extra music in there. I mean, you could still hear everything.
Are you gonna try to, upload it without the extra music?
I mean, the low-quality version got blocked.
Yeah.
That's how I learned that it did so.
No,
it's Scissor Sisters song,
by the
way.
I guess we won't be talking over it, will we? So.
No. So.
No!
It's
not hard. It's not a hard mission, and, you know, whatever. I'm making it look harder than it is. Whatever.
Not really. You don't make it look that hard.
I mean, you're still doing it.
I mean, none of these on retrospect are like, oh, yeah, I definitely did something real wrong. You know, it's just like, oh, today I learned grinding that rail, like, bails you if you fall off of it straight into the neck. I don't know.
Yeah.
Whatever, we're back to the skate ranch.
Whoa,
and here's the end of the game.
What are you doing?
Yeah, here's the end of the game.
Iggy, what happened? Did we have enough money?
It's all mine, man! And now it's time to throw the biggest freaking housewarming party this town's ever seen!
Yeah, let's go party!
You look pretty good on the big screen.
Hey, yeah, the video turned out incredible. Look, Mindy, I just want to say I'm really sorry.
I know, don't beat yourself up. I wasn't gonna hurt, but I'm alright.
So, you're not still PO'd at me?
If I was, I wouldn't have put you on the cover.
Hey, your first edition! This looks outrageous! How stoked are you?
I am very stoked. I wouldn't have been able to do it if you and the guys hadn't made a contribution from their cut of the video.
I'm really happy.
Well, well, looks like you two made up. I guess you told her, huh?
Tell me what?
That Johnny Brownie Points here was the one who floated you the dough so you could get American Wasteland going.
Oh, come on. Look, it wasn't that big of a deal. You totally deserved it.
Hey, get a load of Useless Dave.
I love acting. Yesterday, I auditioned for a part playing myself. I didn't get it. They said I wasn't believable enough. Oh, well, on Friday, I have an audition to be a waitress.
So Useless Dave's hooking up with a lady, and you're not? What's up with that?
He doesn't need to. he already has one.
Nice. Keeping it in the dysfunctional family. I like that. Because you're a
family. Wow.
Yeah.
We did it, boys.
America Wasteland. Yeah. You get some characters for, you know, beating it on any certain difficulty.
Trapped in a deadly video game.
Yeah, yeah. So.
Oh, this song. I remember this song.
Yeah.
I do like this song.
You know, they just have a fun montage at the end of, you know, all the pros. You know. Extra footage.
That's cool. I like that.
There's the Burt slide. The one and only Burt slide.
The Burpin slide.
Yeah, yeah.
The Burpin slide is my trick.
The Burnquist slide.
No, I mean, we're talking over this, so, like, go ahead, you know.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, cool to see everyone.
I'm pretty sure this is B-roll from Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 2. I thought I saw it.
One, probably.
Matt Hoffman has only ever done 5 tricks in his life, and every video part is just, you know, that same footage. Oh, hey, a 540 tail whip IRL.
Yeah.
Remember Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 1? Like, all of the B-roll footage was just kind of...
just them, like, riding around.
Bolivus looking tricks possible.
Yeah.
That's what it reminded me of.
That was so disappointing.
I love that one. I don't remember which one it was. Was it, like, the subway where they're, like, barely even tricking? They're just, like, driving, going around in a circle or something.
I think it was. I think I remember that. Yeah. But, yeah, I mean, it's kind of cool and kind of interesting, the pro lineup that's in this game, you know, like... some people left for Thug 2 and came back, you know, like Andrew Reynolds and Paul Rodriguez. It's some people's first time here, like, you know, Tony Alva, Tony Trujillo. Some people just left, like Eric Hostin, you know, didn't come back.
Oh, I didn't know he wasn't.
So it's kind of like, you know, if they wanted, like, if Activision wanted to, like, cull the roster kind of for Thug 2, I don't know, we kind of talked about that, you know, since so many people... we're in Thug 1 and not, I don't know what I'm fucking... fuck.
Rickolas Thorn?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Rickolas, yeah.
He's not the coolest Rick out there, but he's pretty cool. Tony Trujillo.
All right.
Yeah, well, I mean, to quote Coalesque once again, where the hell is Rick Thorn these days?
Wow, yeah.
I get a lot of mileage out of that song title.
Okay, that's pretty cool. I always liked Mike Fowler's, like, weird, like, hand plant stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is all... pretty sure this is all, like... footage we've seen in other games as well.
I've never seen that Mike Visa before.
Oh, really? I swear it was in another one of these games.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember. I don't know.
Because Mike V was only in the 2 previous games. Oh, here's the man.
That's a classic one. We've seen that one a lot.
Yeah.
I don't remember anything that we've seen in previous games.
Yeah, I mean...
You guys are like, oh yeah, we've seen that one. Oh, we haven't seen that. I have no fucking idea.
I don't even remember, like, specific clips.
Yeah, see, look, there's the tail thing.
Yep.
Because that's how you do it. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I feel like if I were gonna do that trick, I would land my foot on the tail there. And then I would just fly off. I would just
land your teeth on the ground.
Yeah, I'd land my foot on the tail there, and then I'd land my teeth on the ground.
Yeah.
Fuck, I wish she was mine. Green pipes every day, all day. Woo-hoo! Know what I'm saying, sweetie? I'm ready to go big. I was born to go big. I want to go bigger.
I do love how he's just constantly unhinged.
But yeah, then, like, the pros. Each pro does a cool thing with Green Pipes Point.
Okay. Oh, is that a cool thing? Okay.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
I guess that one was...
all right, yeah. Okay.
Man, these cutscene cameras are having so much trouble in this game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like a lot of this would be a lot cooler if we saw it from, like, your character's perspective.
I think at this point, I think officially more characters have done Burt slides than you.
Yeah. At the very least, more Burt slides have been done by NPCs than you.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, hello, we got some breaking news here on Tony Hawk's Demolition Radio, a Sirius Satellite Radio exclusive. It is official. Thanks to all the crew over at American Wasteland, Iggy Van Zandt is now the official owner of the renowned Green Pipes Point Skate Park. There's a massive blowout party happening tonight, so grab your deck, cruise on over, and enjoy the ride.
Yo, 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 yo,
yo, tell Iggy and all your homies. I said, what's up, baby?
Rick Thorne, I'm begging you, please stop.
But, yeah, so the skate ranch, even if you just did, like, the minimum amount, is actually way different now, because, yeah, the Green Pipes Point Snake Run is here. And, you know, it's a cool little snake run.
Ow.
Yeah, but where's the owner of Kona?
Sorry, what?
The owner of Kona, where's the snake run slalom?
Oh,
you can't have snake run without a snake run slalom.
We need the snake run slalom.
I'll be honest, I'm a little disappointed that the snake run isn't green.
Yeah, why do they call this the Green Point Snake Run if there's no green
snakes?
No,
I mean, like, they had, like, it was green in the, like, little cartoony pictures of it.
I mean, it is old and faded, I guess.
That's true.
There's not even a snake in this run. Yeah, what is this?
It did like a reverse Statue of Liberty. You know, the Statue of Liberty got old and turned green. This got old and turned lost not green. Green.
Yeah.
From being green.
What's the color that's not green? I think it's called not green.
Yeah.
Not green.
Yeah.
Not green.
Yeah.
Whoa. Everything is green and not found.
Whoa.
Holy crap.
So yeah, this will be it for, story mode, and I don't know, I'm still debating, like, I don't know, should I get all the pieces and then try to do, like, a before and after of the skate ranch? Because, like, you could just go watch Benedict gameplays if you want to see that. I don't know.
But you throw a card in the corner for him?
Yeah. So that was, you know, story mode, the main mode, but this game does also have a classic mode. We're not quite done with American Wasteland yet. We're going to head over to classic mode and check that out in the next couple videos, so...
Yee!
Yeah.
Yee!